All right, if you're watching this and you want to learn, then grab all the products which I'll be mentioning, like not the exact products, but something which is similar to the product, and we'll get through this together because it's easier to learn like step by step rather than you just remembering it, going back and learning everything. The technique I'm going to show is not a new technique. A lot of people already do this technique, but it works really well, and a lot of people don't know how to do it because it can be a little scary for somebody who has never tried it, and because of the misconception and few theories about makeup, this can be something a little questionable. So I thought I'll just share with you guys, and because this works beautifully. So I've known this technique for almost like 2 to 3 years, and I've been doing it since a while whenever I think I require it. My skin type is combination leaning oily, so I do this technique whenever I feel extremely oily, or that I have a really long day and I know that I'll get oily throughout the day or something of that sort. So the first step is going to be, you can apply primer if you want. I usually skip on primer because I'm not like a major primer believer, but skin prep is really 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 important. So before this, I did my skincare and applied really light consistent serums and moisturizer etc. and prepped my skin really well. So the first step is going to be powdering your face.
Surprise, motherfucker!
I know this sounds a little scary because everybody is always like, do not apply creams or powder, do not apply creams and powder. But trust me, this technique works. I spoke about this technique, I don't know in which video, initially, I guess 6 months ago or something, I spoke about this technique in one of the videos, and it works though, it works, and I really really like it. But I'm going to show you two different ways how you can do it. So first is powdering your face. I'm showing two different types of powder. This is a translucent powder, this is from Laura Mercier, and this is the Maybelline Fit Me powder. So this is a pigment powder, it has color, it has a lot of pigmentation in it, and this is just translucent. I'm going to show you the difference between these two powders. The thing is, both the powders work amazing amazing amazing. The powder you choose depends on your skin type. Maybelline one is not extremely matte, it just sets your face and leaves it. The Laura Mercier one is kind of a little matte powder. If you have extremely oily skin or you get really oily throughout the day, then go for the Laura Mercier one. But if you're like more on normal skin tone or a combo, and but then you do get oily throughout the day, then you can go for the Maybelline Fit Me. I'm going to apply both and show you the difference. When you apply a pigmented powder, what happens is it even adds a layer of coverage. So like you can see, I'm going to compare both the powders for you. I'm going to do the Laura Mercier on the right side and the Maybelline Fit Me on the left side. So I took the powder on the damp sponge. Always use a damp sponge. It's really really amazing to get the product in. So just apply the powder wherever you get oily. I only get oily around this area and around my nose. So I'm only powdering this part. You can powder your entire face as well, but make sure you do it really well. You need to apply powder and press it into the skin. Don't just dust off the powder on the skin. Make sure you nicely prep and blend it into the skin. So since this is a pigmented powder, you can see it even added a layer of coverage for me. It did blur out few of the blemishes I have, and if I go on this if I go with this powder on this area also, it's going to cover that part. But I want to leave it till here because it's the only part I get extremely oily. The rest of the face is fine, and I don't mind having the shine on my cheekbones and stuff because that looks really beautiful. Now I'm taking the Laura Mercier powder and I'm applying this on this side of my face. Both the powders really mattified my face, you can see it, but the Maybelline one gave me more coverage, and the translucent one is just translucent, so it didn't give me any coverage, but it just mattifies it, period. You cannot even see that it's on your face. Like you can't really see that, you know, I have anything on my face on this side versus this side. But both of the powders work really really beautifully for this technique. You can do this technique with most of the powders, but you need to figure out which powders work and which don't. If you have a powder which are not these two, try the technique, but if it doesn't work really well, then that means the powder is not working. So you might want to change to a different powder and check it out. Basically the concept is, so basically a lot of people bake their face, you know, to stay mat for a really long time. I guess it works until a certain point, but let's talk really practically. When you add a layer between the foundation and your skin, which mattifies your skin, it's not going to let the oil peep through and get till the foundation. Whereas when you powder your skin or bake your skin on top of foundation, there's no barrier in between your skin and the foundation to stop the oil control. So the oil is going to come through the foundation and then you have to powder it again and again to make it stay matte. But this technique, what's happened, you already created a barrier and powdered the entire face. This is not going to let the oil seep through your skin through the foundation, which is at the end is going to make your makeup last for really long. It's not going to make you look greasy whatsoever. So next I'm going to take this Maybelline Fit Me foundation. Every oily skin person needs to have this foundation. It's so affordable and gives such a beautiful finish. I really, really love this foundation. But after, you know, mattifying your face, you can kind of go on with any foundation because you already created that layer of mattification. But I'm still going in with this. I'm mixing the shade 320 and 310. Now, I quickly want to tell one story. I don't want this to be like I'm boasting or anything. Like initially when I started getting into makeup, I used to watch like a lot, hundreds and hundreds of tutorials to get better at what I do. So always people used to be like, you know, you cannot layer creams over powders. You cannot layer creams over powders. Now I'm taking the other side of the sponge. This is the powdered side. Don't use the powdered side to blend your foundation. Use the other side. So many people used to always say, don't layer, you know, creams over powders. Then that, you know, made me kind of curious, why cannot I do that? You know, why would that not work? So one day I just randomly powdered my face and started going in with foundation. And I actually really, really, really liked the finish. I really liked it. I loved the way it looked. I was like, this makes my skin look so good and it does keep me matte for a really long time. But back then, like 2-3 years ago, I didn't really see anybody who was using that technique. So it mentally, like, you know, you sometimes, like, when nobody is doing that, maybe, you know, you think that you did it wrong too. So I used to do that technique, but I never spoke about it to anybody because I thought I was wrong. Like, you know, if I say this, people would laugh or something of that sort. But I used to do this behind the camera a lot. I used to mattify my face, especially like all my friends. We used to chill like the entire night. We used to go somewhere or something like that. So I used to always use this because I want my makeup to stay for a really long time and I don't want it to get greasy, because obviously when all friends are there, I don't have really time to take touch up and everything at that sort. Later, what, last year or something, I found Jackie Aina and I saw that she does this technique as well, and I was like, oh my god, I was not wrong all this while. Then after that I came through a couple more people who do the same technique and it still works for them. I was like, oh my god, okay, thank god I'm not wrong. And I forgot why I just said this whole story. Yeah, so I said this whole story because I want you guys to know that if something works for you, do it. Don't think that other people are not doing it. That's the mistake I did. If it works for you, it works for you. If you cannot explain it, it's fine. But if it works for you, then continue doing it. Don't doubt yourself. Just because someone else is not doing it, you don't have to stop doing it as such. So yeah, that was my gyan for today. But my foundation is done. I completely blended it. So you can see that gave me such a beautiful finish. It didn't cling on to any weird parts or anything of that sort. It looks really nice, really natural. It doesn't look cakey whatsoever. It looks very, very beautiful. So for concealer, I am going in with the Maybelline Instant Age Rewind Concealer. So first, I always use the shade Caramel to neutralize everything. I don't have like extreme discoloration around my eyes, but I always like to neutralize it before I go in with a lighter shade. I just add a thin layer of both and then that makes my under eyes look really, really flawless. Only around this area, because this area is a little dark. Like, I like my inner corners to pop a lot. So next I'm going to add the shade medium under the eyes. So foundation and concealer are the only cream products I would recommend oily skin people to apply. Rest everything, let's play with powder. So I'm just going in with the Laura Mercier translucent powder and setting my entire face. One more thing is, since you already powdered your face before applying the foundation, it does kind of already hold on to the product really well. And you know, even if you don't set it, sometimes it works. But you have oily skin, so make sure you set the foundation really well. I even saw a TikTok recently which got viral where a girl was like, you know, just dictating how to apply a foundation, first powder, then foundation. First, actually she told powder, primer and then foundation. But don't do that. If you're going to do this technique, then first do primer, powder and then foundation. Don't apply primer after the powder. It's not going to look good. Now, I don't really cream contour unless I'm doing like an extreme glam transformation. I usually just add a little bronzer and I get it over with. Cream contour is like when I want to do that extreme glam or I'm going somewhere special, or for the day-to-day time I don't really cream contour a lot. And if you have oily skin, I would suggest you to stay away from cream products a lot, because cream products are the thing which usually tend to get really oily really soon. So powders are there to stay and keep you matte for a really long time. Let's go in with the powder contour. I'm going in with my Wet n Wild. This is my all-time favorite. So I'm just going to apply this on the outer parts of my face and bronze it up. Now that you know you set your face really well, you apply foundation and you set it really well, you might feel like your bronzer is not sticking so well, so you need to kind of build it up. Just have a little patience and slowly build up things. If you're somebody who gets extremely oily around the forehead, then you can mattify your forehead as well. So basically wherever you think you get extremely oily, I just applied right here because this is the only area I really get extremely oily, and it's different for every person, so you do you accordingly. Then I'm just going to bronze up my entire nose. To do this technique, I don't really think you need to bake your face again to make everything stay in place or make it less oily, because you've already created a layer between the skin and the foundation which is going to keep your oil in check and it's not going to let the oil peep through your skin. One more difference between the Maybelline and the Laura Mercier powder is that it's like not an exact number, it's just an example. So for example, Maybelline powder will make your face like, you know, stay matte and not get oil, like, you know, become oily for like 7 hours, and the translucent one can make it until 9 hours, because that's a little more matte and oil controlling than the Maybelline one. I want you to go with all powders and mattify your skin as much as you want, because in 1 hour you're going to get that healthy glow, because you're blessed with oily skin, and oily skin is, I guess, the best skin type to have, because you don't age really quickly, and that's like the biggest gift you can ever have. So next I'm going in with the blush. Going in with the NYX matte setting spray. If you have extremely oily skin, then you can go with the matte setting spray. Matte setting spray is nothing, but it does have alcohol in it, so like, you know, it keeps the oil in check, it dries out your face, and or else you can use any, you know, setting mist whatever. But yeah, if you want matte one, matte ones do usually have alcohol in it, so I'm just spritzing that. Always set your face to just, you know, lock everything in place. Next, we are going in with a highlighter. This is the Balm Cosmetics highlighter. So the way you place your highlighter can be really tricky if you have oily skin, because you don't want the shine to be in really weird places, so which will make you look a little greasy. So what I do is I would like just suggest you to apply right here on the eyebrow bone, etc., because those are the places people don't usually get oily. So I'm just going to apply it right here. I'm going to just apply a tiny bit of it just to give me a little shine, and on the eyebrow bone a little. So yeah, that's the base complete. Trust me, try this, do this and see. Would I suggest this for dry skin? I don't think so, because dry skin don't usually get this oily, or you know, they don't usually have a problem for the makeup to last for a really long time. So I would not suggest you to do that, but in case you do, then use a powder which is a little less matte, like something like a compact or anything of that sort, which will just put the shine in check, but you know, won't dry your skin out as well, because you need to be really careful. You do not dry your skin out when you have dry skin already. Oily skin people have a lot of oil, so they can keep it in control, but dry skin people, if they apply powder, the skin is going to make it extremely dry and give you that very extreme weird tight skin feel. So I personally don't do this technique in winter, because my makeup doesn't have any problem during the winter. It's quite dry outside and I don't really sweat a lot during winter, so I don't really go with this technique for winter. But during summers I do really need this technique, but right now though we are not going anywhere because it's quarantine. A lot of people have requested for oily skin makeup, or how to make your makeup last a really long time, so that's the reason I did this video. I'm just going to finish the rest of the makeup and I'll come back. So yeah guys, this is the completed look. You can see how flawless everything looks. Nothing looks cakey, nothing looks patchy. It gives such a beautiful finish. And this will stay for a really long time without getting oily. I'm in love with this mascara. This is the Essence Volume Stylish Mascara. Look at my lashes. These are my natural lashes. Now don't go and apply a cream product over your foundation after you powder it just because Akanksha told it. No, that's not how it works. Applying powder on your skin and then applying foundation works completely different from applying your foundation, then powdering it, and then adding a cream blush or a cream contour. That will make your makeup really cakey and very patchy. That's not it how it works. This powder before cream product only works for normal bare skin. I'm emphasizing this 100 times because that's going to make it look really patchy. Alright guys, it's 6 hours that it's been on, and you can see that it's not extremely oily. It's just the right amount of shine to my face, but compared to this side got a little bit oily, so you can just matte it down with like a sponge or a powder puff. Just you can tone down the shine a little bit, but this is a lot better than what I would get if I didn't use powder on my face or anything of that sort. It's a little shiny around the nose, and I do get a very oily around the nose area usually also. It's been really hot today, like it is extremely hot. My makeup didn't melt down. I'm pretty happy with how everything looks. So yeah, I hope this was useful, and if you guys do try it, then let me know in the comment section. I would really like to know if this was useful for you guys. And yeah, that's it for today's video. I'll see you guys in the next video. Make sure you like, subscribe, and ring the notification bell, and share the video if you like my video. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye.